I just want to kind of put up a video about why I wrote the song "You Need Jesus." I do come from a very religious upbringing. I was the kind of person for a long time that I wasn't afraid to go up to strangers and talk to them about Jesus on the streets. I mean, just about anything that a Pentecostal evangelical would do, I did. I was the speaking in tongues type, and I was very. I debated a lot. I read a lot of books that were way beyond my time when I was 16, 17 years old. Started reading systematic theology books around that age. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed everything about theism. Didn't know it as theism at the time. And I would try to specifically find the most outspoken anti-religious people that I could to try to win them over in debate and arguments. And there was a song that motivated me a lot from Michael W. Smith that went, "For the world to know the truth, there'll be no greater proof than to live the life." A lot of people about things just to appease God, that I thought if you did things with the humble spirit and not do it for any sort of acknowledgement or pat on the backs, that God would reward me. But in my mind, it was like trying to please a father. There were things in my personal life that continued to show that I was being used by a higher power. Things that I don't talk about now. I think there's ways to reason out the way that things happened. Where I am now in life, I do not hold any positive belief in any sort of deity, any sort of spiritualism. Figuring it out for myself, I think, is still where I'm at. Even though it may not sound like it, I definitely do not intend the song to act as an attack against that belief system. If they can't find a reason to live a fulfilling, love-filled, enjoyment-filled life without a God in the picture, I don't believe that person is anywhere near better than someone that lives a fulfilling life without the idea of a God. But I definitely believe people that are able to find reason and purpose to live without the mentality that there's going to be a life after death, I think that's a better person. You develop into a better person, you appreciate life better, if you don't have that in the back of your mind. The idea that there is a deity or some sort of superior being on your side, I think that drains out the genuine spirit that we are, that we have evolved to have, to care for other people, to care about the community, the communities that we live in, to care about the future of our communities, our families. I don't believe a God has a place in that, to secure a stable future. I did a paper for my for a class in college just recently, and I got to choose my own topic, and I chose the genome, DNA and the genome, and all the hindrances that have come from our scientists trying to dissect this awesome and mysterious book of our history, is really what it is, has been ethical and religious ideologies and objections that should not be. We should be working towards a common good, and with there being a deity that is supposed to be determining our morals and our moral bases, it hinders us. It only hinders our advancement. Quite honestly, where the song came from. I've been into debates with other people through Facebook and my personal life, and I'm human. I got frustrated, and when I reach a point of where I just can't talk about it anymore, I pick up my guitar and I write, and that song came out. I have written a lot more verses to it now, and I hope soon to, you know, perfect it. And definitely try to get that song out there to be heard. I think it's a new genre of music that's almost needed in this type of day and age. But not to attack anybody's beliefs that they hold close to their heart. Because whenever you attack something that's close to somebody's heart, they're just going to clam up and you're not going to get to them. You know, they're not going to hear the... Even if the reasons are right, they're not going to hear you. And I truly and full-heartedly believe that it's sad that people cannot find a reason to live or a reason to love without there being a God in the picture. If the reason to be happy does not come from inside of your core, if the reason to be happy does not come from inside of your core, how can you ever expect to be happy? If it has to be, if you have to be motivated by a divine purpose, then you're not living a fulfilled life to begin with. And you're not living a fulfilled life to begin with. And I think that's why a lot of people turn to that sort of thing. I know that I initially didn't. I thought it was just what I was on this earth to do. I thought I was definitely doing what I was born to do, what I was created to do, was to glorify God. And I believe that the mindset that I have now is much more beneficial to everybody that surrounds me and the future.